Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure now to introduce our next speaker, Dr. Marcus Chen. Dr. Chen is the Director of Cardiovascular CT at the National Heart, Lung and Blood Institute at the NIH. So ladies and gentlemen, a warm welcome for Dr. Chen, please.
This lunchtime, I'm going to discuss my experience with the newest Toshiba platform. It's the Toshiba Colion One Vision Edition. Dr. Peters did a very nice job going over radiation concerns. Real quickly here, we know from 2007 that here at the Cardiovascular CT Society, we recognized that radiation concern was a major problem. And a landmark paper in JAMA showed that young females, like the case that Dr. Peters showed, have an increased risk of developing a fatal malignancy during their lifetime. And the risk for a female is different than the male, because for females, breast tissue is in the field of view, and the younger you are at the time of exposure, cancers take a long time to develop, so the risk is higher for a younger individual. At that time, all the scans were retrospectively ECG-gated and had doses approaching 20 millisieverts of radiation. As we know, in the U.S., there's been a dramatic growth in CT imaging, not only cardiac, but also in non-cardiac applications. The annual growth rate in the U.S. has been more than 10%, and this is despite the actual population growth of less than 1%. The U.S. population is about 300 million, and in 2011, there was 85 million CT scans done. So it's almost on average, one in four people is getting a CT scan. There have been concerns in New York Times about medical radiation. Your patients are asking about it, but also it continues in medical literature in terms of radiation concerns. Technologies evolve. We're now doing predominantly prospective ECG gating to reduce the amount of radiation exposure. And then the newest technology, originally about 5 years ago with the Quillian One, is to do whole organ scanning, where you have 320 detector rows, and you're able to image the heart within one heartbeat. So during last year's SCCT, my Quillian One scanner was being replaced with the newest generation scanner. So this is the second generation Quillian One scanner. This was the second scanner produced. The first scanner was in Japan. Prototype scanner. This was the second one produced, and we had we're fortunate to have the opportunity to try to use this scanner specifically for cardiac applications. So, how does the Quillian One Vision Edition differ from the original Quillian One? Well, they're both 320 detector scanners. The gantry rotation time is now faster. The gantry rotation time is 275 milliseconds versus 350 on the original system. The gantry bore, the width, is larger. It's 78 centimeters versus 72 centimeters. They've enhanced the X-ray generator. The scanner can now produce 900 maximal MA, and the previous scanner could do 580. Computers are always getting faster. Images are now recon at 50 images per second. And you also have the same contrast resolution and the same iterative reconstruction, the third generation ADER 3D. Now with ADER 3D, what we in my group have demonstrated that you can safely reduce the radiation exposure by 50% as compared to traditional filter back projection. So here, this is your standard filter back projection image. If you reduce the dose by 50% and use standard filter back projection, this is the image that you get, which is a little bit grainy, actually projects better than on the monitor. But then if you apply ADER 3D, this image quality at 50% of the radiation dose is very similar to the 100% radiation dose with filter back projection. If you look at overall image quality score, the image quality score for a 50% dose reduction with iterative reconstruction is actually slightly better than that of 100% radiation with traditional filter back projection imaging.
Right.
So people in the US, unfortunately, are getting fatter. Red is higher percentage of being obese. And over the past 30 years, each individual state has been getting larger and larger in terms of weight. And the US, this is not isolated to the US. Here in Canada, the percentage of obesity is also increasing. Now, with our initial experience with the scanner, this was 107 consecutive patients. We did not exclude anyone. And what we found is we scanned the typical US patient, where a minority of the patients is actually normal size, a BMI less than 25. In fact, almost two-thirds of the patients were either overweight or obese, and we even imaged people who were morbidly obese in purple with a BMI greater than 40. So this is a nightmare scan. This is someone who is 5'2", about 230 pounds, a BMI of 45. They're huge. And this patient would be difficult to image on any imaging modality, regardless of CT. They have poor echo windows. They would be a difficult cath if you went from a femoral approach. But this patient was 70, had a new diagnosis of heart failure, and they want to exclude coronary artery disease. I reluctantly agreed to scan her. And when she came to the imaging suite, she actually had arthritis of her right shoulder and could not move her arm outside the field of view. So we had to image it with the arm down. So additional attenuation from her arm. And this is the type of image quality. So this is by having a larger X-ray generator and having a larger gantry bore width, you can image large patients. The image quality isn't great, but I can confidently exclude significant coronary artery disease as etiology for heart failure. So with a wide volume scanner, your goal is to do a single heartbeat scan. That way you can minimize any misregistration artifacts between two different heartbeats. I give beta blockers when I can, but not everyone, you cannot decrease the heart rate in everybody to below 65. So again, this is all comers. You know, we had patients that we ended up scanning at very hard heart rates. The highest heart rate was a heart rate of 95. But we're able to do a single heartbeat scan in 95% of our patients. So this is a challenging case. This is a patient with frequent premature ventricular contractions and a fast heart rate of 87. Many people would not attempt this type of scan on their CT scanner. But this is the type of image quality you get. So the scanner has automatic arrhythmia detection. It went ahead and went into a retrospective scan mode due to the premature ventricular contraction. But at a heart rate of 87 with an arrhythmia, you get completely diagnostic image quality. It's a patient with a heart rate of 95. So you can do a prospective scan over two heartbeats, and this is the type of image quality you get. There is very little coronary motion artifact. Yet another nightmare scan. So this is a young lady who had her resting heart rate in the 60s. When she started getting the contrast injection, she screamed on the table. And you can see the motion artifact in the lung windows there. This was programmed as a single heartbeat scan, and it's actually diagnostic at a heart rate of 94. Now, what I like about the Toshiba platform is that it automatically selects the best phase for you for analysis. So this is a patient with a heart rate of 59, very low heart rate, but at the two ends of the spectrum, there is motion artifact. And the scanner is able to automatically select the best phase for you for reading purposes and push it to your workstation. Now, you've heard about automatic dose selection, sure exposure. On the system, we are now able to predominantly do 100 kV imaging. So more than 90% of our cases, we can do 100 kV to reduce the radiation exposure. And this is all automatically done by the scanner. This is a patient who has a BMI of 36. She's obese. So it's a scan at 100 kV, and it's a submillisievert scan. It's 0.7 millisieverts. This is all done automatically by the scanner. So what has our radiation dose been? Well, our median radiation dose is less than 1 millisievert. It's 0.93 millisieverts. Just over 50% are less than 1 millisievert. And I'll also note that about 20% were able to do less than 0.5 millisievert. And overall, 96% of our scans are less than 4 millisieverts. You may wonder, what are these high dose scans, which I consider more than 4 millisieverts? Well, this is scanning all comers. We then select for body size, we then select for heart rate. So these are, some patients were very large, we had fast heart rates, some people were non-sinus rhythm, we did bypass cases, and we also had some combined LV function and coronary artery evaluations. Now in 2009, about 5 years ago, in JAMA, there was a survey of what the doses were in cardiac CT at the time. And between here are all the different vendors. Each line is an individual site, and this shows what their median radiation dose is and what their error bars were. Now, if you look at my experience, initial experience with the scanner, this holds true. We've done more than 400 patients now, that our doses are low, and they're very consistently low. This is an ultra-low dose case. This is a female. She's normal-sized. She's 5'3", 121 pounds, BMI of 21. This is a 0.17 millisievert scan. This is a routine scan. This is where the scanner automatically does the work for you. We can accurately detect coronary artery disease. Here's a calcified plaque, a mixed non-calcified calcified plaque, another calcified plaque there in the LAD, and a significant stenosis in the left circumflex. Again, this is a sub-millisievert scan on someone who's normal-sized. And here's the corresponding invasive angiogram. Very high correlation. You may wonder, how about stents? Another tough case. Here is a left LAD stent. Looks like a significant stenosis within the stent. And here's a corresponding invasive angiogram. Very high correlation of findings that on CT to invasive cath. If you're not looking at coronaries, you can also look at the vascular system. This is a aortic dissection follow-up case. This is actually a patient from another state who called me, who knows I have an interest in low radiation studies. He has a known dissection. He gets yearly scans. He's concerned about his radiation exposure. He called me and said, can I have a scan with you? I said, if you really want to get an airplane. And he said, yeah, that's important to me. So I told him he has to bring his prior studies, especially if he has a known dissection. And he did bring his films. And our scan was 50% lower than his prior scan. So overall image quality has been fully diagnostic. We had two readers, and if you looked at different categories of fine detail, contrast enhancement, noise, or motion artifact, the only way you can get excellent scores if both readers independently said it was an excellent quality scan, but a majority of the studies are excellent quality. Severe calcification. A lot of people would not proceed with a coronary CT if there's severe coronary calcification. Here's a calcium score of over 4,000. This is the quality that you get. This is a combination of factors. This is doing a wide volume, single heartbeat scan. This is iterative reconstruction. This is automatic dose selection. And I can tell you, this is not a stent. This is native coronary calcification. This study is completely diagnostic. And it's less than 1 millisievert in a normal-sized patient. You may ask about what are the doses if you have a combined LV function and coronary assessment. This is a gentleman who had an equivocal SPECT exam. The SPECT exam said that he has an apical perfusion defect and a possible aneurysm. Well, it turns out his coronaries are non-obstructed, and he has apical hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, and this is at 1.6 millisieverts. You get functional information and coronary anatomy. So overall, the Toshiba Cooling One Vision platform enables cardiac imaging at very low radiation doses. And this is due to a combination of technologies. It's due to the wide volume 320 detector row system, the fast gantry rotation time, 275 milliseconds. It has a larger X-ray generator that enables you to do more imaging at 100 kV. It has iterative reconstruction at 50 frames a second, and has automatic exposure control, and has excellent image quality. And this is my last slide. So overall, it's a low radiation scanner, median dose less than 1 millisievert. You can do 95% of scans as a single heartbeat scan. We've done heart rates up to 95 over a wide range of body sizes, and we've had excellent image quality overall. Thank you for your attention.